Mr. Speaker, my question is to the Minister of Conservation. Does she intend to amend the National Parks Act 1980 to enable mining?
The Honourable Dr. Nick Smith.
Mr. Speaker, on behalf of the Minister of Conservation, the National Parks Act does not prohibit mining, but sets very high environmental tests for mining to be allowed. The Government will not be changing these tests or the Act.
The Honourable David Parker.
Does the Minister now agree with the Prime Minister's statement on Tuesday that there will be no open cast mining in current Schedule 4 areas on Coromandel and Great Barrier Island?
The Honourable Dr. Nick Smith.
Of course, on behalf of the Minister of Conservation, she agrees with the very wise statement of the Prime Minister.
The Honourable David Parker.
Oh, thank you, sir. Does the Minister understand that the economic case in MED papers for mining conservation land in Coromandel used figures based on open cast mining?
The Honourable Dr. Nick Smith.
On behalf of the Minister of Conservation, of course the Conservation Minister has a responsibility for assessing the conservation values as part of the review of Schedule 4. The economic issues are for others. However, with respect to those economic issues, the information is poor, and one of the reasons the Minister for Energy and Resources is committed to a substantive investment by GNS is so that we can provide more accurate information on New Zealand's mineral resources.
Have any access consents been granted for mining in national parks? If so, when and by whom?
The Honourable Dr. Nick Smith.
Yes, Minister Chris Carter granted approval for the Hart Creek mine in the Paparoa National Park in 2006. For clarity, this mine is not underground like Pipe River Coal, which was also approved by Labor, but is on the surface and is for gold and gemstones. The approval of this mine in May 2000... The member says it's not in the park. It is. The approval of this mine in May 2006... Oh, point of order, Mr. Speaker.
Point of order, the Honourable Dr. Nick Smith.
Mr. Speaker, two members opposite continue to interject that I'm incorrect. I seek leave of the House to table the access agreement for mining in a national park by Chris Carter on the 25th of May 2006.
Leave is sought to... Well, so long as it's a genuine point of order, the Honourable Darren Hughes.
It's a question about whether or not a minister can interrupt their own answer with a point of order, seeking leave to table documents. You've been very clear on that, and I think it's
order,
a good...
Order, I would have been assuming the member had finished his answer, so after I'd sought leave. But I would have taken it that, so the minister will not be given any further answer after we seek leave to table the document. Leave is sought to table that document. Is there any objection? There is objection.
Mr. Speaker.
No, that, the minister finished it, no, the minister has finished his answer now. The Honourable David Parker.
Is the minister aware that at select committee today, the head of the New Zealand Tourism Board was surprised to learn for the first time that the 70 or so mining licences on conservation areas are not in national parks, as his government's spin would have everyone believe?
The Honourable Dr. Nick Smith.
Mr. Speaker, it's very clear on behalf of the Minister of Conservation, some of those mines are on national parks, including ones approved by the last government. And when Phil Goff said on national radio this morning, and I quote, "Labor never ever allowed mining in national parks," that statement is false.
Chris Ockenvall.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. To the Minister.
Order, I've called the member's colleague.
Thank you.
Order. National front bench members may show some courtesy to Chris Ockenvall.
Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Can the Minister advise the House that with respect to the only areas of National Park being considered for removal from Schedule 4 are those in the Anangahua sector of the Paparoa National Park? And if so, what advice did the Department of Conservation give in 2008 to the government when these areas were added to Schedule 4?
Honourable Dr. Speaker, Nick Smith.
The member is correct. The only areas of national parks nationwide being considered for removal from Schedule 4 is the Anangahua sector of the Paparoa National Park. The House will be interested to know that the Department of Conservation advised against those areas being added to Schedule 4 of the Crown Minerals in 2008, saying that it was not justified. The previous government ignored this advice. It is perfectly proper, given that Labor went against DOC's own advice, that this government is reconsidering the status of that area.
The Honourable David Parker.
Is the Minister aware that it would have been illegal for the Minister of Conservation in the last government to issue or agree to a mining licence being issued for more than 100 square metres of any Schedule 4 land?
The Honourable Dr Nick Smith.
Mr Speaker, the mine that I drew the members' attention to, that Chris Carter approved on the Paparoa National Park in May 2006, is an area that at that time was not included in the Schedule 4. And that is why it is true. If an area is in Schedule 4, it cannot be mined. But the point that is made by members of the Labor Party that they never approved mining on national parks is false.
Speaker. Chris Ockenfall.
Thank you, Mr Speaker. To the Minister, what policy governs mining activities in national parks, and when was this most recently approved?
The Honourable Dr Nick Smith.
Mr Speaker, on behalf of the Minister of Conservation, national parks are governed by the general policy as set out in Section 44 of the Act. The 1983 general policy for national parks was revised in 2001 and the new general policy approved by the previous government in April 2005. The policy approved and endorsed by the Cabinet then, including Phil Gough, states in Policy 10.8b, and I quote, access agreements to prospect, explore or mine in national parks will be considered on a case-by-case basis.
Question number six, Sandra Gowdy. Point of order, the Honourable Dr Nick Smith.
I seek leave of the House to table the general policy statement in which the Labor Cabinet approved mining in national parks on a case-by-case basis in 2005.
Leave is sought to table that document. Is there any objection? There is no objection. Sandra Gowdy, question number six.
Thank you, Mr Speaker.